Hey everyone. In this video, we'll be walking through and understanding the theory and derivation behind Simpson's one-third rule for numerical integration. So, as we've been learning in the past few videos, numerical integration is a numerical technique that can allow us to take a function like e to the power of negative x squared, which cannot be solved analytically, and allow us to approximate the area under the curve by creating subintervals of easy-to-calculate areas, and then adding them together. Unlike Riemann sums and the trapezoid rule, Simpson's rule will use parabolas to estimate the area under our curve. So, let's create our curve here and show what that looks like before going further into the derivation. The first thing we are going to do is divide up our area of interest into an even number of segments. This is the first difference you will probably notice from our other numerical integration techniques that we talked about previously. The reason our subsection needs to be divided up into an even number of subsections is that with Simpson's rule, we integrate two subsections at a time. To make this more clear, let's divide up our area of interest into four equal subsections. Then, we will have one parabola, P1 of x, fit to our points x0, x1, and x2. Then, this pink area here between x0 and x2 is our first area approximation of our definite integral between a and b. And to that, we will add the result of our second parabola, p2 of x, which will be fit to points x2, x3, and x4, and this orange area will be our area under the parabola. Let's recall from our past numerical methods videos that parabolas are just second-order polynomials, which have the general formula of ax squared plus bx plus c. So, let's develop Simpson's one-third rule for numerical integration. To approximate the definite integral, let's begin by developing a general equation for any parabola's area estimation between two points. Then we will move forward combining the areas of multiple parabolas like our above diagram. So, let's imagine a general parabola pi of x, over the bounds minus delta x to plus delta x, over which we are approximating the definite integral of f of x, which we are going to be solving for this yellow area here. Let's begin by substituting in our general second-order polynomial equation and integrate with respect to x at our bounds. This leaves us with a times x cubed over 3 plus b times x squared over 2 plus cx. Now, let's take a minute and apply our integral bounds, and this results in the following equation. From here, we can combine our like terms and factor out terms like a over 3, b over 2, and c. Within our brackets, these two terms will become 2 delta x cubed, and we have a subtracting a negative, which becomes positive. For our second term, these two terms eliminate each other as our squared term turns this delta x positive. Like a, our c term also sums to 2 delta x. This leaves us with the following equation, which I'll just call this equation 0, which we will come back to shortly. We also know that our parabola must pass through three points on our function f of x. The points are shown on our diagram here. Well, from these three known points, we can evaluate our general second-order polynomial equation at these known points. And this gives us the following three equations. Let's begin by adding together equations 1 and 2. As our b terms eliminate each other again, we are left with y0 plus y2 equals 2a times delta x squared plus 2c. Interestingly, if we look at equation 2, we have just c isolated already, and it is going to be equivalent to y1. Therefore, we can substitute equation 4 into our working equation. Simplifying, we can isolate for 2a delta x squared, and let's call this equation 5. We're getting very close now. Recalling equation 0 from earlier, we can do some clever algebra and arrange it into this convenient form that has a common term to our working equation. Therefore, subbing in equations 4 and 5 into equation 6, we get the following equation. Which is a definite integral of our parabola bounded by our step size delta x. Moving back to our earlier diagram, we wanted to approximate the area under our curve between points A and B, for which we fit two polynomials, P1 and P2, which are shown here. Well, individually, as we have just seen, P1 has the formula delta x over 3 times y0 plus 4y1 plus y2. Then P2 has a formula of delta x over 3 times y2 plus 4y3 plus y4. Lastly, we can add together these two areas that P1 and P2 are finding, much like we did with Riemann sums in the trapezoid rule. Doing this and simplifying, we get the following results. Note the trend here, as this is a reoccurring Simpson's 1/3 rule. Our first and last term have a 1 coefficient, and all internal data points have an alternating 4 and 2 pattern. Slightly more generally, because of this, we can write the Simpson's 1/3 rule like this. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how we derive Simpson's 1/3 rule and how to find the areas under parabolas. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.